All right. Imagine you as a father or a mother or whomever you are, man or woman, and you've done everything you could to help your son, your daughter, but they listen to someone else. You've done everything you could from your heart to help your man and your woman, and they listen to someone else that don't have their best interest, but you see they're deceived by them. They're strung out by them. They're pulled. They're enticed by them. It hurts, but you have to deal with it. It almost makes you just want to throw up your hands and say, and people have, just throw up their hands. That's what they did in John chapter 6, verse 66. It said many of Jesus' disciples left him and walked no more with him. And Jesus asked Peter and them, said, are you going to leave too? And Peter said, Lord, where are we going to go? You're the one that have eternal life. And so even if I get angry, and I do, I get hurt, and I do, sometimes my anger is just my hurt, because as a man, they say a man is not supposed to cry, but men cry too. Men are hurt too. So he channels, holds his tears, and the tears come out as anger. The anger comes out in place of the tears. I'm on Team Jesus. No matter what you think, I'm on Team Jesus. That's where I'm at. I'm on Team Jesus. And I am, this says I'm not religious. I am religious. This is just the writing. But I am religious. Or I have a religion, and that religion is Jesus. I have a way of thinking, and that thinking is Jesus. Now let me bring out a scripture that's very important for us. Romans chapter 15, verse 4. That's a second. I already gave you 2 Timothy chapter 3, 16, about all scripture being inspired of God. But Romans 15, 4 says, for whatever was written in former days, that means in the past, was written for our instruction. That means for us presently. So when someone says, oh, that was back then, how are you preaching or how are you living the word of today with a philosophy that was in this book? Oh, that was back then. When Jesus, Hebrews 13 and 8, is the same present, today, yesterday, past, and forever future. Let me show you something. I'm going to come right out with it. I don't care what it is. It's the devil, because the devil is backwards. So the book tells us that Jesus is the same. But people that's in the book, so-called, are saying, but that was back in the 20s. That was back such and such. But the book says Jesus the same yesterday, today, and forever. Here's another scripture. All scriptures given by inspiration of God. So what, God gave it for nothing? Now we're going to go to Romans 15 and 4. For whatever was written in former days, in the past days, was written for our instruction. That means for the present, people of today. That through endurance and through encouragement of the scriptures, we might have hope. So we need men and women to hold on to what's really in here, not take what's in here and turn it upside down or sideways or some other way. We read like this. We don't supposed to be reading like that or like that or like that. We may do it, but we supposed to read like that. Now that was Romans 15 and 4. Now here's another one from Romans. Romans 10 and 17. So faith comes by hearing. You get more faith by keep hearing the word of God, but you got to hear the right word. And hearing through the word of Christ. And I can show you that there's people that have been under the word of God for years and the devil still gets them. Because that's sometimes they haven't never really just given in. They listen, but their mind is searching for other things sometimes. That's the way it is. Or, like Adam and Eve, who were perfect, the devil just knows how to get you. Let me see if there's anything else I want to share with you. My eyes are cloudy right now. I don't know. It hurts to see people well, the scripture, let's focus more on that scripture. What did I say? That was Romans 15 and 4. Whatever was written in the former days was written for our instructions, or for our admonition, that through endurance and through the encouragement of the scriptures we might have hope. There's some scripture that say, as the scripture saith, as the scripture saith. Romans 4:3 says, for what does the scripture say? Abraham believed God, and it was credited to him as righteousness. So we have to believe God. But we want to pray to God and ask God, don't let us get the message of Satan, who's the god of this world, 2 Corinthians 4:4, and we think that that's the message of the Almighty God. Sometimes we can get the message of Satan. Praise the Lord. When we get the message of Satan, we can get the message of Satan and think that we're doing the right thing. No? For the word of God is alive and active, sharper than any two-edged sword. Okay, well, that sounds like Ephesians. For the word of God is alive and active, sharper than any double-edged sword. It penetrates even to dividing the soul and the spirit, joints and marrow. It judges the thoughts and attitudes of the heart. Hebrews chapter 4, verse 12. Okay. Psalm verse 119 says, your word is a lamp unto my feet and a light on my path. When something guides your feet, shows a light to your feet, it helps you on the pathway. Do not merely just listen to the word and deceive yourself. Do what it says. James chapter 1 verse 22. Don't just hear the word. That's what some people say. I hear the word. I hear it. But are you going to do what it says? Praise the Lord. Sometimes I've been felt like this, and I'm not going anywhere from the Lord, but sometimes I just feel like, and I do, sometimes I get by myself. I stay with the Lord, but I get by myself. I don't want to be bothered with anyone, because people, man, you get hurt. They can't help it, though. They living in the world. I'm living in the world. But sometimes God draw you out like a hermit, and then they try to throw that up. Oh, you don't have no friends. Are they really your friends? Are they helping you go to heaven? Or you, if you had a lot of friends and all of y'all in the house burning together, what good is that friendship? I want somebody to get me out of a burning house. Get me out of a burning situation. No matter what they say about you, if you try to hold on to the Lord and do, male or female, no matter what they say about me, you know how you really go on with the Lord? Look at the Lord. Don't look at yourself. After you go through your pity party, and you go through your pain, your depression, and you may never really get over it. But what you do is this. You look at what Jesus went through. What did Jesus do? He died. They killed him. They betrayed him, just like the scripture said, traitors. Sat at the table with him and ate with him, fellowship with him. If you're going to follow him, they may do the same thing to you. They will. It ain't no, I'm a witness. Nothing hurts more than to see probably a parent hearing their child. You ever see these children that act bad in the stores and stuff? Now, they're doing that while they're little. While they're little boys and girls. Now, can you imagine how that feels and embarrassing is while they're little doing that? Now, can you imagine them same little boys and girls doing the same thing when they're teenagers and grown men and women? Can you imagine what God went through? Now take it off of you and put it on God. Now, can you imagine what God went through with Satan in heaven while he got him out of there? Do you see what he went through with Adam and Eve, why he got them out of the garden? Because trouble in the camp, trouble in the house, trouble in the home, trouble on the job. So when you think about, and when I think about what I'm going through, think about what you're going through for Jesus. And Jesus died for his belief. Uh-oh. Let's get into it real fast. I'm not going to. Ephesians chapter 5, verses 22 to the end of the chapter talks about a mystery. A mystery is something that you don't understand unless someone helps you that understands the mystery. And in that chapter, it talks about marriage between a man and wife. It's like the mystery of the church between God and you and others that say you believe in God. That the man is the head, the woman is the body, the man represents God, supposedly. That's why I tell you men, don't get so captivated on the fact that a man's supposed to be a leader or the boss and or the head. Because somebody will say, it doesn't say boss, it says he's the head. Now look up the synonyms of head and you'll find leader, boss. Now, when you lead anything, you boss anything, or you're the head of anything, your head, how is your head treating your body? Are you eating the right things? Are you drinking the right things? Are you maintaining yourself? And even though we try, look how we mess up ourselves. So can you imagine as a head what you can do in messing up a woman? If you're not led right, look how you say you love yourself, right? Come on, man. How often would we have to clean ourselves over and over? Because from the top of our head to the top, bottom of our feet, we're going to stink. We're going to get dirty over again. We got to continue washing ourselves, trying to groom ourselves. And sometimes we slip up on this or we eat this or we eat that. And it does things to our body. Sometimes we get in bad shape. And that's trying to take care of ourselves. We call ourselves caring about ourselves. That's natural, right? So can you imagine if our doctrine with our woman, and we're not even talking about the rebellious women that not going to listen to you anyway. Lord have mercy. That's another thing. But imagine if you have a woman that's going to listen to you. Women that's going to listen to you. Don't you, when you talk about love, don't you want the love that will cause you to care about yourself and really care about where you're sinning yourself and sinning the people and your woman that tell you love them, and your children or whomever. And you love the neighbor just like you love your woman. You just don't have sex with your neighbor. It's, see, the love is the spirit of God. See, you do different things with... See, let me break it down. You go to different stores. You don't go to a shoe store looking for shirts. If you do, not saying that some shoe stores may not sell shirts, but if it says shoe stores, you should know that's where shoes are. Say shirt store or clothing stores or lumber or ice cream. Different stores are for different things. You want to be in the right capacity. So there are, in everything that I name, there's a human being there. But in a carpentry store or a carpenter is about carpentry. A painter is about painter. Not to say that the painter doesn't know anything about carpentry or the carpenter doesn't know anything about painter. But if you go to a painter, you're going to him for painting, not carpentry. You go to the carpenter, you're going to him for carpentry, not paint. Go into a politician about politics, etc. You got different men for different things. But this is basically about no man, because you can't just put your trust in man when it comes to Christ. But you're looking for the Christ in the man. Did Christ call you to be a man of God? You don't have to be a reverend, a bishop, or an apostle. Are you a man of God? Are you a man of God? Are you teaching what God teaches? Are you staying with the scripture? Don't go outside the scripture. The scripture says, how can a young man stay clean on the path of purity? By living according to the word. Psalm 119:9. Luke chapter 11, verse 28, he replied, blessed rather are those who hear the word of God and obey it. Isaiah chapter 48 says, the grass withers and the flowers fail, but the word of God endures forever. We die, but the word of God don't die. Because in the word of God, if we're in the word of God, we'll live. But we die to sin and we die to flesh. As for God, his way is perfect. The Lord's word is flawless. He shields all who take refuge in him. Psalm 18:30. We want to get in the word of God. Therefore, everyone who hears these words of mine, Jesus says, and puts them into practice is like a wise man who built his house on the rock. That's Matthew chapter 7. Now in Matthew chapter 7, verse 21, it says, not everyone that says to me, Lord, Lord, will enter into the kingdom of heaven. He said, many will say they cast out demons. Remember on that teaching where the woman says, well, you might didn't hear it, but she says to the man that told her she's not supposed to be an apostle, she said, I cast out more demons than you, and men come to me, and men get delivered through me, and demons are cast out, and all kinds of stuff. Now, we're looking at the word, 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 7. I don't know why I said verse 7. 1 Corinthians chapter 11. This book is made upside down. It's crazy. Actually, if there was scripture in this book, if there was scripture in this book right here that I was reading, I would have to read it, and it'll look like I'm reading up. You would say, that guy's not reading no scripture. But in the actual book, no, that's not upside down right there. But there are scriptures in here that are written upside down. Hold up. Look, okay, the book is right side up, right? I don't know if you'll be able to see this or not. Them words are upside down. Praise the Lord. Sometimes we're just upside down, man. The devil comes and twists us around. The devil knows how to sell us a bill of goods. But anyway, back to where I was, because I'm just going to do two more here. Just because it looks like everything is right, when the scriptures show you something is wrong, like if I show a woman what the Bible says, she's going to come up with something else. If I show the homosexual, don't trust me, trust the word of God. I just told you, I sin sometimes. I don't want to, but I do sin. Somebody said, well, if you sin, you must have wanted to. Okay, I'm not going to argue that fact. The main thing, I'm not telling you to trust me. I'm telling you to trust the word of God. That's what I'm pushing. I'm not pushing you to follow me in sin. I'm not pushing you to follow me in something that I made an opinion about, meaning this is supposed to be facts, supposed to be. That's what I go by. I'm not saying, well, I think this and I think that. No, when I tell you something, I'm really saying, I say the book said, when I say 1 Corinthians chapter 11 says that God is the head of Christ and Christ is the head of man and man is the head of woman, and then you tell me as a woman or a man, oh, it's not like that, and we operate opposite of that particular scripture, and though we're operating in opposition to that, demons are cast out, men are getting more delivered than they ever get delivered. The men that say they don't believe in women preachers are not casting out demons, but and where they don't let women preach, they not casting out devils, but where we let women be in control and men are sitting under women, they're casting out devils, and the deliverance service going on, they're coming to Christ, and these men love sitting under these women. But the scripture says, not everyone that says Lord, Lord, so they are saying Lord, Lord. They are saying they cast out devils and prophesying. But Jesus said, not everyone that comes to me, Matthew 7, verse 21, and says, Lord, Lord, shall enter. And he said, they're going to say, like they argue, are we casting out devils? Folks are getting delivered. We're going all over the world. We're on TV. We're making money. We're rich. We're popular. Look what we're doing. But he said, he's going to say, I know you not. I never knew you. Depart from me, you workers of iniquity. But you said you was casting out devils. You said you was prophesying. You said, look at me. And you down me. I'm a little guy. I'm a hermit, right? I'm the guy that's worthless. I'm the guy that's not popular. I'm the one that when people listen to me for a while and come close to me, and then they end up and go in and dispersing somewhere else because I'm not accepted by the master. But Jesus died by some of the same masses that laid palms down for him. How we got Palm Sunday. Here comes the one, blessed Hosanna, the ones that came, the one that comes in the name of the Lord. Then next week they crucified him. That's how we got Easter. The same ones that said they was on his side crucified him. Then in John 6 and 66, the same ones that ate with him, talked with him, said they believed him, turned their back on him. Jesus said in Matthew 7, 21, yeah, they're going to say they cast out demons. They were popular in the world. But he said, I never knew them. Depart from me. Now you figure what side you on. I'm on Jesus' team. And I do enough wrong by myself. I don't need to join up with a bunch of people that I see that's going right against the scripture. And I'm going to follow them. If I was chasing women, every woman that says she can preach or prophesize or be an apostle, I mean, if I was chasing women, she'd tell me I was wrong. I'm not supposed to do that. Because even the most strongest so-called women, they don't want no man cheating on them. Oh, they'll go to the Bible on that. But when you show them what the Bible says for them, they don't believe it. Man, know what you're teaching your woman, especially if your woman's listening to you. And if she's not listening to you, you still, if you're going to be with her, you should know what to teach her. And woman, if you're going to be a helpmeet, are you going to help him with Jesus or are you going to help him with the devil? I'm so sick. not because of any of you. These demons in the world is just... I seen how the devil works. The Bible says, be careful how you entertain strangers, because you may entertain angels unaware. That means good angels and bad angels. You meet people with the Holy Ghost that represent God. You meet people with demons in them that represent Satan. And they all talk. And Satan, the sharper Satanists, the sharper demons will talk about God to pull you over. I'm finished. I can be talking. I am. Blah, blah, blah. Jesus loves you. Every grandfather, every father, every son, every grandmother, mother, and daughter, that includes you. God bless you. Hopefully you got something out of it. Subscribe. Even if you take your name over, subscribe. Just keep your name on your subscription for at least a week if you can, or a day, an hour, just to show that you were there. If you want to. If you don't, who cares? I care about you in Jesus. The subscription is not important.